that's like begging the issue now, because who now is going to help the people to know they have to stand up when most of the leaders themselves are already part of the other side of the story?
Well, while I'm not advocating for violence in the country, but we've seen what happens in other countries. In the Middle East, for instance, you're talking of Tunisia, you're talking of Egypt.
Yes.
I mean, the people can do it. Some people have mentioned, well, the way things are going, the military are going to come back. I don't think the military is going to come back.
I was just
going to
ask you that, because
I don't think, okay. I very much doubt, because it's a passing phase.
And we have gone through that phase.
Yes, we've gone through the phase, and we've recognized that the civil government
society, yes,
is the best of all any other type of government. So what I'm saying is that if the people really don't want anything to happen to them, they are the people who can rise up and say, we don't want it. And it's not going to happen.
You also had some experience with Nadeco,
yes,
at the initial stage of it.
Right.
So, looking back now, do you think we are no longer interested, or we are no longer capable of raising the same kind of resistance?
No, I think because of the natural resources that this country is blessed with, Nigerians tend to just lay back
and wait for their time.
Well, I wait there for their time. What we recognize as poverty level here is not what other countries do as a yardstick. So we're still eating, we can afford little drinking and everything. So people don't even take the issue serious. But we are forgetting that we are modeling up the space for our children and grandchildren, yet unborn.
Now, you have a publication, a book out. Can you just give us a summary of that book?
The title.
Can we have a look at it?
Honor for Sale. This is the book.
Okay.
Right there, Honor for Sale.
Yes.
And it's about honor on which the military tradition is built. Once it's violated, there's no military again. And that's the point that I'm trying to make.
So you're saying that the military tradition must have been sold out, or must have been bargained off?
It's been violated. It's been violated several times, and during my service in the country, I've witnessed it at very close quarters, where those of us in the government then did so many things intentionally to bastardize the economy, to mete out injustice to people, to silence people, to oppress people, and so on and so forth.
And these things were not part of the military tradition.
It's not part of the military tradition, and that's honor. The military tradition is built on honor, and once you lose that, there's no military again.